Okay, we are back at you guys again. We are back again at you guys with a different male this time. A different male this time. And we have Chris here and we have Lord here.
I've been back. This is my second time back.
Right. This is your second time back. So everyone, you remember Lord, right? Okay. No. All right, you guys. This is none other than the Foxy J.A. coming back at you guys again. So the topic for today. This is a juicy one. So ladies, listen.
Okay.
The topic we are going to talk about today. You guys, and you can answer as you please. What do you think about ladies and that always say, I'm not going to reveal my body parts because a man don't respect you when you reveal your body parts. I'm going to keep a turtleneck on and maybe long sleeves and I'm going to button this all the way up to the top because they'll love me more, they'll respect me more, they possibly may even want to marry me or take me home to show me to mother, to introduce me to mother. Either one of you guys can speak. What do you think?
I'm going to let my man go. I'm going to let my man get it. I think it's more so of...
Okay, speak up.
I think it's more so of a person's first impression, presentation that you may give that first time you meet, because you could actually cover all the way up, turtleneck, blazer, and all that, pantsuit for a woman, and still come off, excuse my language here, and have like kind of whore tendencies, you know? That doesn't, justify, like, if you're...
Hold it right there. Go ahead. Hold it right there. But what I want to tell you is just say it like it is. I mean, put it out there.
Okay.
Put it out there.
And we're going to get out of the way.
We're going to build a suite, but, I mean, you know, I mean, we're not at church, so, I mean, okay. You can kind of calm it down, but okay. Just put it out there.
Nah, but, I mean, if she's covered all the way up and I see her out, and you say, if I see her and she's dressed, and but her actions are showing otherwise, you know what I'm saying? Like, she's out here, you know, busting it wide open out here as the rest of you.
Well, what do you mean by busting it wide open?
Dancing, you know.
Dancing, okay.
Dancing, you know.
And so you're talking about in the club.
Yeah, if I see her in the club, she's in there like she just came out of business meeting, but she's getting loose, then, you know, forget what she got on. My mind goes into, you know, let me see if I can get this.
Because she has a turtleneck on and she's dancing.
That don't mean nothing.
And she's dancing kind of wild and loose. Isn't that what you do when you go to a club?
No.
You dance?
And
you get loose when you go to a club?
It's all about actions. It's presentation. You could show your shoulders or have something like you got on right now and still carry yourself as a lady in classy and still get that respect.
So when you say like a lady in classy, I'm not saying that classy ladies don't go to clubs.
No.
But I'm saying when you say classy and like a lady, you carry yourself. We're talking about the clothes issue now when you reveal it.
No, more so her actions.
So which one would you, if you was in a club and the lady was revealing and then there was one with, I'm just saying, a turtleneck or all buttoned up, mm-hmm. Which one would you kind of lean more toward?
I'm going to look at that one that got something halfway on, just because that's just what I came to the club to see. I came to the club to see some girls that look good. And you know, even though a girl with a turtleneck, she might be my second or third choice, I might look at her and be like, yeah, she look like she can hold herself. She look like she classy. But at the end of the day, she just might be just as freaky as the other girl is that ain't got nothing on. And the girl that ain't got nothing on,
yeah,
you find out that she ain't freaky at all. So you like, what?
Bomb.
I can't talk to you no more. I thought about it. You know what I'm saying?
Right. So I don't know whether either one of you guys ever thought about, you know, being serious with a female, really selling down and getting a good female. And if you have thought about it, the one with the turtleneck on versus the one with, you know, just what I have on, just a little revealing, little arms out or whatever. I mean, does it make a difference? Or is it actually the person's personality that you are looking for?
I'm looking for personality because, like I said, it shows, like when you come in the club, and for you, you see a man, you know what I'm saying, he can have on a suit, and his demeanor say that, I'm from the hood, I ain't no good, Then vice versa, you see a man with some jeans on and a t-shirt, and you saying, you know, he talked like he got some common sense. I mean, it just might be what that person had on that day. But for me, depending on what I want. Okay. You know, if I want that classy lady, I'm gonna go say something too. I might say something to both of them.
Okay, okay.
How you doing?
Yeah.
So the whole deal is what I'm trying to get to is that, do you lose respect at all for a woman that's a little bit more revealing than one that's more covered up? Is there any kind
you
of
you might be cautious. You'll be, yeah. Can you say you be cautious?
Yeah, you have to use the yellow light on that one.
You'll have to use the yellow light.
We'll
say that.
With your own cause.
So that's what I'm saying. You use the yellow light on one that's a little bit revealing, right?
Yeah.
Right.
So the one that's covered up, what do you use on that one that's covered up?
You use the between the green and the yellow.
between the green, yellow, and there's no blue light. Between the green, yellow, and
she
red.
I might be more comfortable, or I might be a little more open to her, vice versa, the girl that's, you know what I'm saying, got it all out. I might just tell the girl just two or three more things, you know what I'm saying, that I would tell somebody else.
You know, because ladies, I'm a lady myself, and ladies so often that I hear them say that, a man, he want to take a good woman home to his mom and introduce her to her mom. He don't want to take a slut home to his mom because she's a little bit revealing, a slut home to her mom, to his mom. He don't want to do that. So what do you guys think about?
I think it depends on that man's definition. Because I know some guys out here, you know, that took some females home and been all the way loose, you know. And, I mean, that's what they into.
Okay.
I think it's really on that definition of that guy.
Yeah, if he feel like being around her, I think, you know what I'm saying? Like, if he feel like kicking it with her and he feel like that he can take her around the family, then, you know,
And I guess what I'm trying to really, I don't even know if I'm hitting right where I want to hit, but what I'm trying to get to the ladies to understand is that because you don't have a little bit of this revealed or whatever, that doesn't make you a good lady because, and a decent woman because you're not revealing anything. Because there's a lot of ladies that's in the closet. And some that's revealing is not, you know, they're not in the closet.
Now I'm gonna tell you this, I can pinpoint a gal and tell whether she freaky, whether she in the closet, you know what I'm saying? I can look at a girl and tell. You know, even if she in a beauty shop and she got one of those black things on, mm-hmm. and I can look at her face and be like, yeah, she with it. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And she could be from church. Okay. The church ones be with it.
Yeah, we want to talk about the church ones. Now, I don't know how long we have here on this, but
freaky.
I mean, this is getting hot in here, you guys. It is getting hot. So I want to talk about the church ladies now.
Church girl.
So, you know, they're sitting all in church and, you know, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, thank you, Jesus.
I've had one of those too.
You know, so I want to talk about that, you guys. I mean, they are in the church every day. They are in there Monday through Sunday. They are in the church and they supposed to be so holy. And I mean, so what do you guys think about the church ladies?
I can't speak. I ain't really never had no church woman. Well, I'm sure I have had one, but I never had one that I knew that she was doing her church thing. And if she was, it was just on her own time. And if I found out that she was in church, I kind of slide off because I know she probably looking for something a little more than what I'm trying to give her at that time. So I kind of slide off from that.
Well, being in church, just because they're in church doesn't mean they even...
Yeah, but I don't want to go against the God thing. You know what I'm saying? You know, if they in church and they say I got problems and I take advantage of that, then I feel like I got to deal with God on that, and I ain't trying to do that one.
What about the girls that's coming in church? I mean, you know, when I grew up, you know, and I know all of you guys have your own religion, you know, but I grew up like pretty much Pentecostal. You keep everything covered and you know, all of that, and no short mini skirts coming in the door with those juicy thighs out. When I grew up and I came up in church, none of that. But now the churches, I mean, they're coming in juicy. They're coming in with everything hanging out, everything.
I be looking.
When they sit down, they got the nerve to be pulling. And I'm like, what are you pulling for? Because you came in this church like this.
And get mad when I look at you. Why you gonna get mad when I look at you for when you know what you got on?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I had a girl came to the church and she was new there. And I love church. I love Church America. I do bad, but I love church. But you know, she came to church.
Bless
and,
your little heart.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let the glory.
But you know, I came to church and the girl, she seen me and she wanted to holler at me, and I was like, look, get in church a little more because you need to find yourself. And she really wanted to holler at me, and I was like, I really ain't with it. 3 months down the road, she bring another girl, another dude in the church, and they got a baby now. You know what I'm saying? She look at me, and she look at me and be like, she shake her head, and I just shake my head, and I be like, it's better him than me because, shoot, I wasn't ready for that, and, you know, that could have been me.
Yeah, that's
been
true.
Fatal.
That's true.
That could have
been
fatal.
Yeah.
That could have been what?
Fatal.
Lethal. All right, that's why I ain't do it.
So when they come into church like this and you guys are, and you're in church and they come in church like this, I mean, what do they got to tell you? Are they coming in for something? Are they in search of something? Not Christ.
They might be. I don't know what they in search for. I don't mess with it. I'm going to meet you outside the church. And then if you do your church thing, you do it over there. And then when you with me,
chick I was messing with, she was a daughter of a preacher. But, like, she wasn't just, you know, all week, all about church. She was out here, and she done her thing and on some Sundays, and she made it. You know, it was church, and sometimes she wasn't.
And then they have the nerve, and I'm talking about ladies, they have the nerve to invite you to their house, and they invite you there at 9 or 10 o'clock at night. What are you going to do with them ladies? Are you going to have Bible study? You going to, what, pray? I mean, what's going on, ladies, when you invite me guys to your house after a certain hour? For what?
On that Saturday night when you're supposed to be getting ready for church in the morning.
I'm not gonna go there. But what are you thinking, ladies, when you say you are a Christian, you love the
they
Lord?
They get lonely.
I get lonely. Come on, Lady Williams. So, I mean, ladies, you inviting them to your house at night, and then soon as they start reaching over and rubbing. Oh, I don't do that. I told you that I was in the church of God in Christ, and I told you I'm a holy woman. What's up with that, ladies?
Yeah, why would I put myself in that situation? Because I ain't got time. That's why I don't mess with them, because they undecisive, really. You know, at one minute, you know, you might want to do your thing, or, you know, we're going to say the devil be tempting you. You know what I'm saying? If you want to, you know, let that go. And, you know, you might invite somebody over and you might get over there and realize that you don't want to do it or whatever case may be. So, you know, you might say that. But at the end of the day, I don't like messing with them like that.
Okay.
I need you to know what you want.
Okay. So you hear that, ladies. We will be back again. But you hear that, ladies, what these two gentlemen just said. And this is for all females, plus size females. I mean, whatever size you are, this is for you coming from a male's perspective. We'll talk to you guys later, and it's none other than the Foxy JA, and thank you guys for coming and letting the ladies know how you feel.